गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। सो टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑन द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी। इन अवर अर्लियर लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड 3 to 4 केसेस लाइक व्हाट इज स्ट्रेन एनर्जी, हाउ द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी इज बीइंग एनालाइज्ड फॉर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ लोडिंग लाइक ग्रेजुअल लोडिंग, सडन लोड एंड इम्पैक्ट लोड। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर विल बी डिस्कसिंग द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी ड्यू टू द सेल्फ वेट, मीन्स a bar who is having that much heavy that it has got its own weight. Like you might have seen a wire or an electric wire between the two poles, and due to its own weight it get a deformation in between that. You can very well view that. It's not a deformation, you can say the inclination happens to that. So due to that self weight of the material, the body get elongation within itself. And that we have to analyze, and on that basis we will also analyze up to which extent the elongation happens, so that we can design the machine part accordingly. So in our today's session, we'll be discussing the strain energy due to a bar which is suspended like that. So this is a bar whose length is L, and this bar has got its own weight. That we will also see how to calculate the weight. Let us have the length of this bar is capital L. We will assume a strip over here whose length is dx, cross sectional area is capital A, and it has got a distance of small x from the bottom. So this is the basic detail of this bar, how this bar is suspended. And this bar is attached to one end or fixed at one end, another end is fixed, means this part is under gravity. The lower part, the complete part is under gravity, means the its own weight is acting onto it so as to elongate it. Let us see, the weight of this bar can be calculated as volume into the density or the weight density. Weight density means if we multiply it with small g, means the density with small g, that is called as the weight density. If the density get multiplied with g, the gravity, it means it will be called as the weight density. Now, if the density get multiplied with volume, then it is called as the weight. So, first of all, since we are assuming a section over here, we are assuming a small strip whose length is L. First of all, we will calculate the weight of this section up to x, means at this strip the weight acting downward will be, the weight acting on this strip will be up of this weight only, means this weight will be applicable on this strip. So we'll be assuming this weight only. So weight of this bar up to the length x, means of this length x up to this length x, can be calculated as A, cross sectional area, into length, area into length, that is your volume, into rho into g. So this is the A into rho into g into x. This is the weight of the bar up to the length x, which is applicable on this strip. For with moreover will also be responsible for the strain into this bar of this strip length having length dx. Let us calculate similarly, since we have calculated the weight applicable or the load applicable on the strip or the section axis, you can call it as a section axis also. So how much stress is being developed in this strip due to this weight up to the length x? So that can be calculated, means load divided by area. Load means the weight Wx upon area. Now sectional area is uniform throughout the bar. So sigma x is the stress induced into this strip. So sigma x will be equal to Wx ka value humne yahan se ye rakh diya. The value of Wx is A into rho into g into x. Area से area आपका cancel हो गया. So sigma x is the stress induced into this strip due to the weight of the bar up to the length. So this is sigma x rho into g into x. I am keeping it here itself. Now let us see the another part of this derivation. We know we have been studying this thing that the strain can be given as longitudinal strain can be given as sigma divided by E stress upon Young's modulus, or Young's modulus can be given as stress upon strain. From this relationship, I have written this relationship. Now, from this relationship, I have to derive how much strain has been produced in this strip. In this strip, whose length is L. Means, इसके ऊपर इस स्ट्रिप की जिसकी लेंथ dx है, जिसकी लेंथ dx है, इसके ऊपर जब यहां से यहां तक का वेट लगेगा तो इसकी लंबाई में कितना इलॉन्गेशन, कितना इजाफा, कितना प्लस होगा, कितना बढ़ जाएगा. हाउ मच दिस dx विल बी इलॉन्गेटेड ड्यू टू द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ wx. लेट अस सी. सो वी कैन राइट द लेट अस सी दैट डेल्टा lx बी द चेंज इन लेंथ और द इलॉन्गेशन और ए स्मॉल इलॉन्गेशन इन टू द लेंथ dx ड्यू टू द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द wx कैन बी रिटर्नाइज बाई दिस. सो फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला वी कैन राइट इट एज डेल्टा l इक्वल टू सिग्मा अपॉन e इन टू द ओरिजिनल लेंथ. सिंस वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द चेंज इन द लेंथ ऑफ dx ड्यू टू दिस लोड wx, दैट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड सिग्मा इन wx sigma x. The length of the strip is dx. E will be L. So this complete relationship shows the change in length of the small strip dx due to the application of wx. Now let us see where dx, I have also mentioned it in the derivation also, where dx is the length of the path at the section xx or the strip where which we have assumed. Let us see. Now I am again writing this equation as over here. Delta Lx means the change in length due to the application load wx. Sigma x into dx upon e. Now I am putting the value of this sigma x from this relationship, where the value of sigma x is rho into g into x. So put the value of sigma x over here, rho into g into x. Dx as it is upon e. I am putting it here. Now we have solved the equation for the strain energy up to in our previous relationship or the previous derivations. That is, the strain energy is given by sigma square upon 2e into area into the original length. Let us convert this relationship for this dx. Since we have been assuming or we have been analyzing this part by considering a small strip whose length is dx. So let us see, due to the application of the load wx on this small strip, how much strain energy has been stored. Let us see. So the strain energy for the length dx of the path, that is given by ux. Means ux, sigma will be replaced by sigma x since we are analyzing for the strip. 2e will be as it is, e is the Young's modulus. A is the area, A is the cross-sectional area, that will also be as it is. But the length we are analyzing over here is dx. So the length capital L will be replaced by small dx. Now let us see the another part of it. Now from this relationship, the strain energy stored in the strip will be equal to u into dx, will be equal to sigma square x. Sigma x cross square upon 2e into area into dx. Let us see. Now again put the value of sigma x. The value of sigma x we have analyzed is rho into g into x. The whole square ho jayega upon 2e into area into dx. So this is equation number 1. Now I will integrate this equation to find out the strain energy stored in the complete bar due to its own weight. So integrating from 0 to the complete length L. So complete length L, so analyzing this equation, opening this equation, so that is rho square g square into x square upon 2a to area into dx. Again, this x square get integrated as x cube by 3 by putting the limit 0 to x. By again solving the limits, I am getting this this relationship, rho square g square a into l cube upon 6e, this is u l. Earlier it was u into u subscript mein dx. Now it has been replaced since we have integrated it for the complete length, so it will be replaced by the capital L. So after solving, the complete relationship comes as L. We can further solve this relationship, or we can further reduce this relationship. Let us know. We know that rho into g into area into complete length. Length L is the length of the complete bar of the from 0 to L. So that is W is the weight of the complete bar. So into rho into g into a into L, we will arrange it in such a manner that is W square upon into L upon a into L. We'll arrange this equation by this relationship, and we can further reduce equation. This equation, we can name this equation as equation number 2, and further we can also say this is equation number 3 after reducing it by putting the value of W. Such a great, that is very simple equation. So this was over. Now let us solve another derivation, that is or try to understand the strain energy stored in a compound bar. Compound bar means in our earlier case that we have just solved, in this case we have been observing that the cross-sectional area has been constant from 0 to L. It has not changed. If the cross-sectional area from the bottom to the top of the bar is constant, that is capital A. But as far as compound bar is concerned, it may or may not be possible is that the length of, first of all, the cross-sectional area from the top to bottom will not be constant. Point number one. Point number two, it may also be possible that the length of these two bars which are attached to each other, they may not be equal. They may be L1 equal to L2. So what will happen in this case? How the strain energy will be analyzed in such a case where the compound bar is. So let us see, if this is a compound bar which is suspended in such a way, and due to its own weight, or you can say if the load is applicable, P load is applicable onto it, we are applying a load P over here, how the strain energy will be stored? First of all, the force taken by the each member will be same. That is quite obvious because it is working in down. So P1 will be equal to P2 equal to P. So P1 can be written as sigma upon A1, because sigma 1 will be equal to P1 upon A1, and sigma 2 will be equal to P2 upon A2. Sigma 1 equal to P1 upon A1, sigma 2 is P2 upon A2. So since the load is same on the both the bars, so in that case sigma 1 A1 equal to sigma 2. Point number 1 to be noted. Second point, the total deformation in the complete bar from the top to bottom will be delta L, and the elongation in both the bars will be added, means delta L1 plus delta L2. Point number 3, the strain energy, in a similar fashion, the total strain energy will be added, that is capital U will be equal to capital U1 plus capital U2. Now, let us understand today's last topic, that is the strain energy stored in a compound of composite section. Composite section means when the material of the two sections, they are combined to each other, is different. Means the bar is made up of two materials. Like you can say two materials or more than two materials. Like you can say it's a concrete block or a bar, concrete column of a concrete, that is an example. Or moreover, many other examples which are made up of more than two metals or the two materials. Let us understand the strain energy stored in a composite section. So we have taken a composite section over here. You can say this is this color, it's a violet color, and inside is a yellow color. So two different are there, material number 1 and material number 2, whose point number 1 is very very important to be noted, that their Young's modulus will be there. up to now we have been observing that the Young's modulus have been constant throughout because the material was single. Since here the material are two in number, so due to the material change in material, the Young's modulus will also change. That's the first point to note. Second point is to be noted that the deformation in each member will remain the same, so as to keep the material as symmetrical or the machine part as symmetrical. Let us see, this is a machine part, here violet color is there. So this is your base, this is your load or a weight which falls on this base due to the falling of this load P from a height h. This base get a elongation of delta L or a deformation of delta L, and due to this deformation, strain energy is stored into this composite section. So let us see how the strain energy equation follows for this composite section. So since we have said that the delta L1, in you can say this is delta L2 and delta L1, they have to be same. If they are different, the machine part will fail. That is not enough. So please remember this point. If the deformation in both the cases will be different, then the machine part will fail. So the deformation in both the materials is selected or restricted in such a way that their deformation is kept for the same. So delta L1 will be equal to delta L2, or delta L1 again can be written as sigma 1 L1 upon E1, because we know the relationship that epsilon is the symbol of strain, is equal to the sigma upon E or delta L upon L. From this relationship has so E1 and E1. Clear? Now, total strain energy is given by U equal to U1 plus the strain energy stored by material number 1 and stored energy stored by material number 2. Now third point, the work done W equal to P into H plus P is the load applied or the force applied, H is the height from which it is falling, and delta L is the further deformation. This relationship we had solved in our sudden load case or impact load case. So this was today's session, and we have completed or seen almost all the cases of the strain energy, how it can happen. In our next session, we will be solving the numerical. Thank you.